more firmly to participate in our democratic process. Unfortunately, these midterm elections, a lot of people don't show up and they're not as interested, but as you all know, these are really important elections. Because a lot of this is quality of life, which is the stuff that we see every day here in Miles. So I haven't talked with you yet on Tom Hochschild, the county commissioner in District 3, professor of sociology at ESU. So I do a lot of community service with my students. In fact, just about all my students have to do community service in Miles, so I've kind of developed a reputation for doing community service and helping the Haven Better, the Men's Shelter, the Children's Miracle Network, LAMP, a lot of these organizations. So about six months ago, I'd say I started campaigning, and one of my goals has been to knock on doors in, on every street in Miles County. And at this point, I've been to getting close to 4,500 doors that I've knocked on. I've lost 10 pounds, I've got an extra hand. But it's been great talking with folks about some of the issues that are on Miles residents' minds. Just really briefly, I'd like to talk about a few things that I've been hearing over and over from Miles residents that I would like to address. One, I hear from VSU students as well, is that there aren't enough family-friendly activities in Miles County. So what happens oftentimes is young people graduate high school, or they graduate college, and they leave, and they go to Atlanta, they go to Savannah, Jacksonville, Greenville. They don't stick around. That's bad for families, it's bad for our community, it's bad for business. So one thing I'd like to do as county commissioner is to kind of enhance and promote family-friendly activities. And so what I've done is I've started working on a website called loungeevents.com. I've started building this website. And I envision it being a website, a one-stop-shop website, where all community and civic events that are taking place in Miles County, as long as they meet certain criteria, get posted on this website. So if you're looking for something to do on the weekend, with the family, with the kids, you go to this website, and here's all the different things going on. Over and over, what I hear is people saying that they didn't realize there was a great event going on last week. Had they known, they would have gone to that event. So I think this would solve that problem. Another thing I've been hearing from a lot of residents, they're upset with the way that Sable Trail and Ford Light Power have been treating landowners. If you're not familiar with Sable Trail, Ford Light Power, they're proposing a 36-inch pipeline through a lot of people's yards. And I've had the opportunity to talk with a lot of people who would be affected by this. Some of them are family members, neighbors, friends, and some of the behaviors have been downright rude on the part of Sable Trail. And with Ford Light Power, they sent friending letters, they've been rude over the telephone, and so what I'd like to do is hold them accountable. If they're going to come into Lowndes and they want to use Lowndes property, at the very least, they need to treat Lowndes property owners with civility, which they haven't been doing. Finally, local business. Another issue, VSU students, a lot of them leave because there aren't enough good-paying jobs. And so, I think a lot of these issues intersect. A lot of you are familiar with the sewage that comes up from the streets when the rain's heavy in certain parts of Miles County. Not only is that a public health issue, but it drives residents away. It drives businesses away. I mean, we've got low taxes, and that's great, but when businesses type into a search engine, Miles County, and they see stories popping up about sewage going into our streets, that raises a red flag. That's got to be a top priority. It's bad for families, it's bad for kids to play near the streets, it's bad for business. We've got to fix it. We've got highly educated, skilled people coming out of these colleges, VSU, Wiregrass, Georgia Military College, Moody Air Force Base. There's no reason we shouldn't be flourishing with a lot of good paying jobs. We've got great weather, a lot of things going our way. I think what we need to focus on is promoting Lowndes County is an educational epicenter. I think that's one thing we really have going for us, is we got a lot of smart, talented people in Lowndes County. But we just need to promote that. There are a lot of places with low taxes around the country. Why should they come here? Well, we've got smart, educated, potential workforce for you. So if elected, these are three of the top priorities that I'd like to work on. A lot of you gone to VSU, or to send your kids or your grandkids to VSU, or your nieces and nephews who trust me with their education. I haven't let you down. ask any of my students, any of my colleagues, they'll tell you. I bring it every day. I demand excellence out of my students, and I'm going to bring that same passion, I'm going to bring that same dedication to improving and enhancing the lives of Lyle's families.